Hello viewers, today I am going to demonstrate you how to perform a diagnostic hip injection. Today we are going to do an intra-articular injection for a gentleman who has got back problems as well. And clinically we think it's the hip that is giving him pain. However, in your clinical practice you will find a lot of times it's very hard to determine whether pain is coming from the back or from the hip. I would recommend that in those cases either give a nerve root block in the back or give intra-articular injection to the hip to delineate whether it's the hip or it's the spine that is giving the problem. So there are many ways to do an intra-articular injection. I will show you a technique in which we are going to use lateral approach. You can use anterior approach, you can do it with ultrasound, or you can do it with fluoroscopy. Today we are going to do a lateral approach with fluoroscopy on this gentleman, and we will do an intra-articular injection. So this will be the setting for the injection. The CR will come from the opposite side. We have prepped the area that we are going to inject. The leg has to be in slight internal rotation to see the full profile of the neck. That makes your life much easier. So there are many described ways of doing the hip injection. You can go from the front or you can go from the side. I would like you to learn a few techniques. So I have marked, this is the ASIS, anterior superior iliac spine. This is the greater trochanter, and I have used C-arm to mark it. So the first line that I have drawn is from ASIS, which goes to the center of the patella. And the second line starts from the tip of the GT and meets with the first line. So this is our meeting point here. Now from ASIS to GT, I have divided this roughly into 1/3 and 2/3. So there are many authors who have described different techniques. If you want to do this under outpatient as an OPD procedure without image guidance, then you can directly go here in the front, and once you hit the neck, because the whole idea is to hit the femoral neck and to be inside the capsule. So once you hit the neck, you can inject after withdrawing. The second technique is that this is our target. This is we are aiming. So if you are using a spinal needle, so you start from this 1/3 and 2/3 junction and aim towards this target point, and you should hit the neck and you can inject this as well. However, I like to go just from the top of the GT, and I will show you how I do it. So today we are going to use a lateral technique, lateral approach to inject. So this is our local injection that I will use to anesthetize our track. This is the OmniPEG that will be used to confirm the location of our needle, whether it's in the joint. And this is a spinal needle, around 21-22 gauge will be fine. And this is the steroid mixed with some local anesthetic that will go into the joint. So first thing is to inject local, and I have checked it. We'll just go roughly a centimeter above the GT and we'll inject the whole track so that the patient doesn't feel pain when we are injecting. So I use the spinal needle to inject the whole track, because sometimes you may require multiple penetration, so you don't want to give pain to your patient. So this is our whole track infiltrated. So I'm going to use the same needle now, following the same track, and I will check in the fluoroscopy whether I'm at the right place. So now you can see that our needle is on top of the GT, and I'm just going to angle it slightly on the top so that it hits this area. We are aiming for the lateral aspect of the neck. You don't necessarily have to go into the hip joint. So I'm aiming for the lateral aspect so that it is just underneath the capsule. So now this is our position, and looks okay, but I still have to check with OmniPEG whether I am inside the joint or not. So initially I tried and it was not going, so I had to readjust my position. So now you can see that contrast is nicely flowing. It has gone inside the capsule and it has taken the shape of the femoral head. So now we are sure that the needle is in the joint. So always use the dye so that you are always 100% sure that your drug is injected at the right place. So once I am happy that I am in the right place, what I do is I just try to suck out as much dye as possible. Sometimes it's possible, sometimes it's not. Especially in small joints where you have got limited capacity for drugs to give, it's a good practice to see if you can take out something. And lastly, of course, you need to inject the steroid into the joint. So if you're in the right place, you will find some resistance, but it should still flow freely. And as gone in, you will see that the dye that was seen before, if you take any fluoroscopy now, would be completely gone. So if you prefer an anterior approach, then I just want to show you where you should be. So take an AP with the needle, and if you look at the fluoroscopic image, so after putting the needle in the front, your needle apex should be in the center of this area, and this is where your needle should be, because this is where the capsule is. And once you are happy that this is in this position and you have reached the right place, I'll show you what you have to do. So if, say for example, this was the position that we were aiming for, all you need to do is to make your needle go perpendicular and go straight onto the neck, and you should pierce the capsule and you should be able to inject. However, I would always say use OmniPaque to confirm your position before injecting the drug. So this was a short demonstration on how to do an intra-articular injection of the hip. If you have any doubts whether the pain is coming from the hip or the back, I would recommend you should use a diagnostic injection in order to find out where the pain is coming from. In our patient, his 100% of the pain was gone. That tells us that hip is the cause of his pain. I hope you find this video useful. Do like this video. Do subscribe to our channel and do share it. Thank you.